In this video, we'll compare Rust with Zig programming language. Specifically, we'll use Actix HTTP framework for the Rust and Zap framework, which is written in Zig. To run this benchmark, I will deploy both applications to Kubernetes. Then I will measure their CPU usage, memory usage, and client latency, focusing on P99 percentile. We'll also measure how many requests each application can handle. Additionally, we'll measure availability of each service, which is a ratio of successful requests divided by the total number of requests. Since both apps deploy to Kubernetes, we need to measure CPU throttling as well. And this is actually the first time I've been able to generate enough traffic to overload both Zig and Rust applications. As a DevOps engineer, we deploy almost everything in Kubernetes nowadays. So I prepared a production-ready EKS cluster in AWS and used newly released M7A EC2 instance types. To run this test, I have a couple of Kubernetes node groups. The first one is dedicated to applications, and the second one is used to deploy clients that will generate some artificial traffic. For the application node group, I use extra large instance type, which has 4 CPU and 16 GB of memory. In production, we always set requests and limits for each application. In this case, I allocate only 2 CPUs and 256 MB of memory. If you can scale application horizontally, you would typically limit it to 4 or 6 CPUs, but not more. So this test is something many will find familiar. For the clients, I use larger nodes with 4 extra large instance types, which have 16 CPUs and 64 GB of memory. To generate load, I use Kubernetes jobs and spin up 20 pods for each application. This gives a total of 40 pods generating traffic. I also use a regular service of type cluster IP for service discovery. Then we gradually increase the load until both applications fail, and at the end we'll review each graph for the entire duration of the test. I chose Actix framework for the Rust because it was the fastest framework I tested in the previous video, where I compared Actix, Axum, and Rocket. Feel free to check out that benchmark. I also have a source code for the applications I test in my videos available in my public GitHub repo. On the other hand, I'll be using Zap framework, which is basically a wrapper around a C library written in Zig programming language. Based on the benchmarks provided by the project, it seems to be more efficient than Rust. However, I'm not going to reproduce those benchmarks. Instead, I'll test these applications in real-world scenario using the same deployment strategy and environment that I would use for any other production application. For tests like this, I typically create an array of objects, in this case, array of structs, and return them to the client. I found that Zap framework has a very small buffer for sending responses to clients, and I was able to send only a single device. Let me know if there is a way to send larger payloads. Otherwise, this framework doesn't seem practical at all. Also, I usually use default settings, and I have noticed that in many cases they use 2 threads and 1 or 2 workers. Since I'll be deploying this app in container, there is no reason to run multiple worker processes inside the container. If you need to scale, you simply increase the replica count of the deployment, not the number of processes inside the container. Alright, let me deploy both applications to Kubernetes and let them run in idle state for about 10 to 15 minutes to get a baseline. From a CPU perspective, Rust has slightly higher usage, but for some reason, Zap uses much more memory. Doesn't have a garbage collector? Well, I don't think so. Let's take a look at the actual memory usage in bytes. Rust only uses 760 kilobytes, which is almost nothing. You can also see a green line for the resource requests defined in the pod spec and the red line for the limit. Since the requests are equal to the limit in this graph, you can only see the green line. Now, let's take a look at the Zig application. It uses 22 megabytes, which is still a small size, but much larger compared to Rust. If you know what's going on here, please let me know. And we have the same requests and limits set for the Zig application as well. For example, with Prometheus operator, the requests and limit settings are different, so you can see both lines on the graph. It's not really practical to focus on exact numbers, because you would need to create a bunch of different alarms with different thresholds. It's much better to use percentages relative to the limit. Actual usage in bytes might be useful if you are a developer trying to debug or test a new feature. In that case, it could be helpful. We can also measure CPU usage not only as a percentage relative to the limit, but also using actual values and create lines for the requests and limits. Alright, let me go ahead and deploy test jobs to generate some load. As I mentioned before, I have a Rust client that starts with a single virtual client. Then, every 30 seconds, it adds additional client, each running in its own thread. I'm using Tokyo runtime to run those clients concurrently. It's not the most efficient way, but it allows me to gradually increase the load and test the application, so it works for my needs. I have also set a timeout of 200 milliseconds, since a typical request only takes up to 1 millisecond. So if it reaches 200 milliseconds, it means application is slowing down and is already overloaded. This test took around 2 hours, but I'll compress it to just a few minutes for you. Even at the beginning of the test, you can clearly see a trend. Rust uses less CPU and its latency is lower compared to Zap framework. The longer we run the test, the bigger the difference becomes. Around 80% CPU usage, the Zap application starts to degrade. The latency increases and we see spikes in memory usage due to many pending requests. I would say that around 80,000 requests per second, Zap application hits its limit and can no longer process any more requests. From this point, CPU usage reaches 100%. As the test continues, the latency for the Zap application keeps rising and you will occasionally see timeouts for the Rust application. However, the number of timeouts is really small and doesn't affect the Rust application's availability, which stays above 99%. At around 100,000 requests per second, you can also notice that the latency for Rust starts to increase, and there are some drops in availability. Let's go ahead and run the test until Rust begins to fail as well. At this point, you can see Kubernetes started throttling both Rust and Zig applications. Eventually, we reach the maximum number of requests Rust can handle, which is around 160,000 requests per second. Now, let me open the graphs for the entire test duration. First, we have the requests per second graph. You can see a significant difference in how many requests each application can handle, even with pretty much the same number of threads. In this case, Rust only sees a single core in the container. Then we have memory usage graph. Zig has much higher memory usage, and if you know why, please let me know. Then we have CPU throttling graph, which by the end of the test started to affect both applications. After that, we have, I think, the most important metric, the latency for each request. The difference is quite significant. Let's also take a look at the latency before applications started to fail. Next, we have CPU usage graph. You can see that Zig application uses much more CPU. Finally, we have availability graph. a few Rust requests timed out because I set 200 millisecond timeout, but it's within the norm, and most people wouldn't notice any timeouts. That's pretty much it for the tests. If you can improve any of the applications I tested, feel free to create a pull request. I'll test and merge it. And if there is a significant improvement, I'll definitely make updated video to share results. Also, check out my benchmark playlist. You might find it interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.